What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Dou Cup. It's going to be the second best two of the day, Energy Pacemaker, the favorites to maybe even win the entire thing, and Newbie Miracle, the third newbie team. Yes, they do have three. I'm Mike Lawrence, going to be joined by Grandis for this best of two. What do you expect to see out of this game, man? I don't think Energy Pacemaker really going to be slowed down by too much. They've been kind of rolling through everybody.
Yeah, absolutely. If we take a look at the standings inside this tournament, Energy Pacemaker have gone 3-1-1, meaning that they only lost one series, and I believe that was to Tong Fu. Outside of that, they've been looking really solid, and Newbie Miracle, unfortunately, have not been looking so hot. They've lost every single game they've played, with the exception being one game against VG Gaming Potential, and even that was under some very interesting circumstances, let's say. A lot of lag and accusations of throwing the game coming out from VG Gaming Potential. So it's not a pretty picture for Newbie Miracle, just slightly above Terrorblade when it comes to power rankings. So very Energy Pacemaker favored when it comes to, in general, their play and individual performance. But the good news for Newbie Miracle is that, at least in the early game, they do make good rotations. The fact is that they just get outlaned, so they probably need to draft accordingly and just draft a vast amount of strong heroes in the early portion of this game, and maybe that'll allow them to somewhat punish this Bounty Hunter pick coming in from Energy Pacemaker. He does tend to weaken your lanes a little bit.
And for Energy Pacemaker, for what I noticed to be their biggest weakness is the fact that they, you know, they perform pretty well in the lanes. It's in the mid stage after they do very well where they kind of go off by themselves and do really stupid things, like have a Shadow Fiend pushing a lane by himself with no tier 1 tower to take, or and no tier 1 tower to get any backup from. So like plays like that from Energy Pacemaker kind of set them back and really prevent them from being like a really great team, I think. Just like tightening up the screws and making sure that they don't play super out of position would be super helpful. But the problem is, with when you get that problem, when you are kind of always out of position, the enemy team, when they do make good rotations, very easily punish that, especially with a Storm Spirit opener. So Newbie Miracle, as you said, they're already pretty well positioned to make these really good early game openings, whereas for EP, they grab what I assume to be their two supports right off the bat, something we don't really see all that often anymore.
And as far as these supports are concerned, they don't necessarily set up kills by themselves. They're very good setup supports. Bounty Hunter can set up with the slow coming up from Orb of Venom, Janata early on, and just being able to rotate around the map invis, and Rubick has his telekinesis. But as far as damage potential is concerned, unless you get a lot of track gold on Bounty Hunter, and I mean a lot to where you can build in some actual right-clicking DPS, most of these heroes are just reliant on utility. Not to say that that's a bad thing, but they are going to suffer maybe a little bit, since a lot of these top-tier mids and safe laners are going to be banned away from them. Shadow Fiend is banned out by Newbie Miracle, and Gyrocopter banned by Energy Pacemaker.
When you have, like, all these, as you said, lots of early setup, you need heroes that could stand on their own. That's where Shadow Fiend comes in, that's where Gyrocopter comes in. Yeah, they offer other things in not just the early game stages, but Shadow Fiend has raises, Gyrocopter has Rocket Barrage, they can do quite a bit by themselves. There aren't really a ton of heroes in the game that actually do that. Like, there are, I mean, there are a lot of them that actually do that, but there aren't many that are necessarily going to be picked that are really popular nowadays. Spiritbreaker's pick for Newbie Miracle. Between that and the Storm Spirit, they're going to get a whole bunch of initiation. We've already seen it in the previous series. These two work very, very well together because they can always pick their targets, especially up against a first pick Bounty Hunter. Tracking someone becomes incredibly risky for EP. They do grab a DK, however, and he's going to be resistant to the vast majority of this, just having such high armor.
Yeah, and in general, just a tanky hero is going to build into a lot of HP, presumably get a fairly fast BKB, maybe backs off for a Shadowblade Blink or a Silver Edge before that, depending on what next couple picks are from Miracle. But yeah, we'll just have to wait and see how this works out. In general, I think the Dragonite, although he is a great hero to have on your side and does well in lane against Storm Spirit, but yeah, a Luna pick coming out from Energy Pacemaker.
Now, I love me some Luna, man. She's like one of my favorite heroes. This is the proper lineup that EP had the proper lineup to fit in a Luna, but this is not a good game to be Luna up against Newbie Miracle. It's one of those situations because Luna excels when her DK gets initiated upon, takes a couple hits, takes a couple of stuns, then she runs in with the BKB and eclipses everyone and starts bouncing things to death. That is not going to be very easy, considering there's a Spiritbreaker and a Storm Spirit and a ton of bursts on the Newbie Miracle side. Like, Lina and Lion, they got the two pew-pews, and Luna is not exactly a tanky hero. So yeah, the upside for Luna is certainly there, but the risk, man, the risk I think is a little bit too much to say in this game that I truly like this pick.
Yeah, Newbie Miracle's lockdown is absolutely incredible, and it's going to force Dragonite and Luna into very quick Black King bars, and that is kind of a double-edged sword. If they're not able to push down with the high duration on the BKBs, things could get scary very quickly for Energy Pacemaker if they don't make those fights happen. Then you're stuck with 5-second Black King bars against the Lion and Lina, aforementioned. You're probably not going to be able to burst them down in that 5 seconds, and after the fact, you're going to get a face full of Laguna Blade and Finger of Death. And even if Luna gets quite a lot of farm, unless she Manta dodges one of those, she's probably going to end up dying. It's a Pugna ban coming out from Newbie Miracle, and I think that's a reasonable ban, but yeah, just in general, I'm liking Newbie Miracle's draft a little bit more. It seems easier to execute.
And if Newbie Miracle just grabbed, you know, maybe a little bit of a lighter early late game hero, someone like a Juggernaut who could hold down the fort a little bit earlier, then they'll be just fine. Energy Pacemaker clearly on the plan of, we're going to be aggressive, we're going to constantly hunt for some kills. If we get the kills, fine. If not, we could even just straight push your towers with the DK and the Luna. So they might be going like all in at this point. They still probably are looking for an offlane, although another support would not go amiss in their lineup either. Put the Bounty Hunter in the offlane. For Newbie Miracle, yeah, they're going to need perhaps a little bit more of that late game security, but honestly with dual lanes right now, it seems pretty reasonable for them. As long as the hero can kind of fight early on, they should be fine. I think just across the board, I like Newbie Miracle's draft a little bit more, but honestly with the fact that they're going up against freaking Energy Pacemaker, they will need a much better draft if they want to have a chance in this game.
Yeah, and I think that's also something that we need to keep in mind. In general, though, I'm liking their chances. Something like a Slark could work well for them. Just any hero that comes online quickly and can capitalize on the fact that there's so many avenues for initiation. And I don't know, more is almost always better, unless it comes at the cost of some of the other facets of your game. If it's not going to be something that's going to fight directly, maybe like a Lycanthrope could also work nicely for Newbie Miracle to secure that they have the tower pushing power to back up those fights. But instead, it's a Razor. Kind of a mix between both, in all honesty.
I was kind of hoping for an Ursa there, which is, you know, whatever. Probably, I'm not too upset that it's not there because the odds weren't that high to start things off. But if you know that the enemy team is going to be playing aggressively, then you could brick wall them right from the get-go and just crush their lanes. The lane in the mid is probably going to be DK. I guess EP, they probably can't really switch that up at this point. The DK is going mid, and he has, you know, not the worst matchup against Razor, in all honesty. Yeah, it's really bad, but the fact that DK can't last hit with his sword is usually not that relevant because he never does that anyway. Like, he always is on the breathe fire plan, so Razor will have a great time. That's pretty much a given. But that is, of course, assuming Razor's going mid up against DK, which still might not necessarily be the case. It's a Phoenix last pick for Energy Pacemaker. That is a little bit more interesting. Like, they have a good amount of AoE, a good amount of team fight. Their pickoff potential is pretty high. But Phoenix is a hero that typically struggles in the early game stages, especially up against this amount of chasing power and this amount of CC coming out from Newbie.
Yeah, if you replace the Bounty Hunter with something like an Earthshaker, Energy Pacemaker's lineup looks a lot better. They just don't have the appropriate stuns, at least in my eyes, and appropriate heroes to protect the Luna and protect the Phoenix when he's trying to get off the Supernova. So we'll just have to wait and see. I think Energy Pacemaker, their individual plays on a different level than Newbie Miracle, so the game is by far not over, but I do like Newbie Miracle's draft. And let's go ahead and introduce our sides. On the Miracle side of the map, it is going to be Chang playing on the Spirit Picker, followed by Christina on the Storm Spirit, KK on the Razor Origami on the Lion, and 621 on the Lina.
And for EP, they're going to put Fawn on the Luna right now, 5400 on the Rubick. Old Chicken is going to be playing the DK with Lei on the Bounty Hunter. That'll be Xiao Tu Lei on the Phoenix. And, well, I was about to say, they do have effigy of a Phoenix, so they're probably pretty comfortable with the hero, but it's not the correct person's effigy, so clearly Xiao Tu Lei is just a terrible Phoenix player. That's the read I got. Yeah, that's not serious, guys, in case anyone didn't realize that. But we do have a rotation from Newbie Miracle up towards the top lane. Odds are they're going to be leaving two heroes here at least. Maybe they're going to put Christina on the bottom lane. I don't know. They have so much flexibility knowing that DK most of the time is going to be going towards mid. And really, no matter what I think Newbie's lanes ultimately end up as, they should have advantageous lanes almost across the board.
Yeah, unless there's Yeah, honestly, I don't see a way that Energy Pacemaker could shake it up to where they could get dominating lanes against Newbie Miracle. There's going to be an Earthspike thrown on the Bounty Room just to make sure that there's no Bounty Hunter there, but little do they know, Lei is currently behind enemy lines and maybe going to look for a Courier Snipe. They have some decent vision around mid and bottom, and he's positioned in such a way that he could, in theory, go for it, but he'll just pop his invis and then stick around a while longer. He's going to bump the line, and ooh, I'm getting a lot of lag, and it looks like the players might be too. We're paused.
Kala, Origami, I think is going to get hit by this Bounty Hunter. He is most of the way towards the hit, I think. So he's going to blow the invis right now, and there is Boots on the Lion, however, so this is not exactly the hero that he wants to go for. What he really wants to go for is the Lina, who's trailing behind the Lion just a little bit, but Bounty Hunter's already going to make his presence known. He is going to be an annoyance to the bottom lane, to the bottom lane supports, to the mid lane, but ultimately, this Bounty Hunter, unless he does get those Courier Snipes, is not really going to get that much done in these lanes. I don't see him getting many kills in the bottom lane unless these supports get really out of position and Xiao Chulei is there with Icarus Dive and Fire Spirits. And killing off a Razor with a DK sitting in the lane is damn near impossible for a Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, it's not a good situation for your Romy Bounty at all. And I think, for the most part, the most he can hope for is a Courier Snipe, and even that's a little ambitious. Lei probably just going to soak experience until he can get to a point where he's super relevant. And honestly, I think that's pretty much what's going to happen with the Phoenix too. I'm still stuttering quite a lot, but for now, it's reasonable enough. I'll stick with it.
All right, so up towards top, we have a Luna Rubick dual lane versus, well, I mean, it honestly doesn't really matter who they're versus right now because this dual lane isn't incredibly strong. Yeah, they get the extra damage from the Lunar Blessing, and that plus 14 is actually a lot more relevant most of the time than it really sounds. The problem is that they have no kill potential here. Their zoning potential is very limited as well. Like, 5400 can poke at Chang, but he's doing, like, 20 damage a pop with those Stout Shield procs. This Spirit Breaker is going to get a lot of experience. I don't think he's going to get that much gold since the Luna hits quite a bit harder. But killing off Chang really is only going to happen if Chang makes a mistake, like getting way too close. But even with then, he has a salve, he has a lot of regen. This Spirit Breaker is going to be just fine.
Yeah, and the same can't be said for the Phoenix. Every time Phoenix tries to go up to the creep wave, he's going to get barraged by Rykoks coming out from the Lion and Lina. And even though he does have a Ring of Protection and a Mango, that's not enough to keep Phoenix alive. Ooh, Spirit Breaker? Yeah, and a lot of trouble going to be lifted up, pulled back into Fan with the right click damage. This should be our first blood drawn. He'll salve, but to no avail, they'll loosen beam him down.
Now, Telekinesis has a very, very long cooldown, but they get the lift up in the Spirit Breaker, bring him back in. He had a charge the entire time, just decided not to use it, and crucially for EP, they also get the Bounty Hunter into the area when the kill happens, so he gets a little bit of experience gained from that as well. Man, of course that was just after I said Chang is rather unkillable in this lane. He gets way too far ahead. I think the fact that he's trying to get gold is probably the fact that got him killed there. Like, settle for experience in this lane, because especially after that first death, you are not invulnerable. You're just super tanky.
Yeah, absolutely. And after that, it is going to maybe tip the scales a little bit on Energy Pacemaker's side, but even so, the Phoenix is still struggling a lot. Under tower, he'll find himself level 2 or herself, whatever Phoenix is. But yeah, Phoenix isn't going to be able to contribute as much as the Spirit Breaker. Right now, Spirit Breaker could, in theory, go for a gank into mid lane. Maybe kill off Old Chicken, although it is reliant maybe a little bit too much for his liking on bashes. At least there's that possibility. For Phoenix, there's no real backup plan. You can't go into jungle camps this early on. You can't farm Ancients. You can't really gank that convincingly. So whatever he gets out of the lane is what he's stuck with.
Now, the good thing for Phoenix here is that if there are no supports, and Lion Lina are supports that are very prone to roaming, especially when this happens, oh, this just sucks. I freaking hate this neutral camp, it's so bad. But yeah, since they don't have that pull, they will be more inclined to roam toward mid. And yeah, killing off a DK is very, very possible with the amount of burst damage, but sitting in lane versus Phoenix, not super attractive right now, and Phoenix versus Storm Spirit, especially when they're both level 3 as they are right now, is actually a pretty good lane for the Phoenix. Yeah, occasionally he'll trade right clicks, and with his lack of armor, Phoenix is not really going to have a great time, but the Storm Spirit can't zone out the Phoenix, so he's going to get experience since the Lina and Lion are more inclined to leave. So this may end up winning them this lane, this one Observer Ward in the pole camp.
Yeah, the Observer Ward on the pole camp, in my opinion, I think that the fact that this is so hard to deward for the Radiant supports is a buff to the Dire offlane, especially when you look at the Dire small camp that has one sentry that pretty much takes away all of the spots, yeah, over in the trees, as Mike is pointing out. But yeah, that's going to help out quite a bit for Energy Pacemaker. Even so, the Radiant offlane is still preferable, at least in my eyes. But Chang right now is going to be playing a little bit of a dancing game with Rubick. But with Tangos there and with the threat of a lift, Chang's going to eat a lot of Rass. And they might even try to go for this kill. They'll pull him back in. Chang is very tanky and has a charge. And it looks like he's going to use it this time around. He'll be safe.
Just barely, though. He used the charge, and that actually bumps the Luna back. If that didn't happen, there would have been a quick Lucent Beam. Maybe the Spirit Breaker still lives because he gets a little bit of distance away, but still, it's a very delicate situation since, EP, first of all, just played that one very well. They waited, they used Lucent Beam first, waited for the Telekinesis, so they always had that CC effect, or for the most part in that lane, they had the CC effect there if he decided to charge out. It lapsed for a little bit, and that got the Spirit Breaker away, but still, Luna's getting quite a bit of cash, is going to go. Just for a Wraith Band for right now, not going to get anything too advanced. We do have Origami stalking Xiao Tulei right now. There's the Impale. There is a Hex here as well. Unfortunately, a little bit late on the draw. Phoenix gets very far away. Does, however, force the Phoenix to miss the pull. And with the DK and Luna on the side of EP, this Ancient camp represents a lot of potential gold.
Yeah, and even though the Phoenix can't directly farm those Ancients, the Phoenix can still benefit from having the experience from those camps. It's going to take a while longer before Luna and the DK can take those up, but it is an asset that they'll want to have on their team. But oh, mid lane, they'll pull up the Razor back into the Dragonite, but there's no mana for the Dragon Tail. And it looks like with a little bit of help from Origami, he's going to be able to survive.
Killing off a Razor, as I said before, is really, really difficult. If they had a Dragon Tail, I think they probably would have been able to actually go for that, but Old Chicken has been spamming out his Breathe Fire the entire time just to hold control of the lane. You can't really expect him to have mana to Breathe Fire and to Dragon Tail. That's 220 out of 299, and that's a steep, steep cost for the DK. Yet still putting a little pressure into the Razor is going to get Old Chicken a slightly better time as he does get a little more experience in CS under the tower, a little bit cleaner there. And the rotation for the Bounty Hunter, like, so far, not really giving him all that much, but hey, at least he's trying to poke around and trying to find someone, because he knows that bottom lane, when the tower, especially when the creeps are pushed in so close to the tower, he's not going to find anyone. Top lane, he can barely contribute to killing off the Spirit Breaker. There's not much that he can do. 5400 is getting charged right now, and as a Rubick, you can, if you see it coming, lift him out, and there it is. Cliff him? Well, okay, he's going to throw him to the other side and then book it to the north. That's not the play that I expected, but it may get him out of here if there's no bashes. That first bash kind of had to land. Now it seems like he's fine, although Razor is pretty darn fast. It's actually another charge, and 5400 is going to die. Okay, well, charge only with like a 10-second, 11-second cooldown, and that plasma field hurt like hell. But Chang's going to run right into an eclipse. One beam's going to connect, there's two, and he runs into the creep wave, which is actually really going to help the Luna if she's on point with the right clicks. Really just the Lucent Beam's all she needs. Chang's going to go right back in the creep wave, gets hit with the glaive, and dies. Yeah, you never expect a massive stack there. In the meantime, bottom lane, they're going to jump into Christina right before he has his ball lightning. Breathe Fire is there. It'll take him down. Lazy need a lot of experience from that one. They may even go for a little bit more in the Lina. Carving through the trees is the Phoenix. Another LSA is available, but Old Chicken has no Dragon Tail at the moment. Gets hit with an LSA. Now Dragon Tail is available. Lei is not willing to dive this tower with the rest of his side. Old Chicken does secure the kill, but it will cost him his life. Xiao Tulei is going to teleport out, and Old Chicken bottling and running. There's a charge. Dragon Tail, though, gonna brick wall that one. There's a spike. No mana for Hex. Old Chicken may live yet. And I think he will. There's no Nether Strike. There's a charge in 5 seconds. Old Chicken not getting any help. Where's the help here? Someone help this Dragonite. He's kind of a valuable hero. Lei shows his face just to distract Origami. Old Chicken will finally go down. Oh man, where's the Phoenix there? Where's the Rubick there? They really needed more heroes. They could have actually turned that one around if they had more TP support.
Yeah, it would have been really nice for them to do so. In general, though, the Dragonite's having a pretty poor game. If you compare his CS to that of the Razor, he's almost getting tripled up. And this is a problem that I think Old Chicken runs into quite often, at least from what I've seen from Energy Pacemaker. Whenever his laning stage goes well, it goes really well. But whenever it goes poorly, it also goes very poorly. And although it is a bad lane for the DK, I'm honestly surprised that he isn't just getting more based on the Breathe Fire span. He should be getting out-farmed by the Razor, but not by this much.
At least he got to the bottom lane. At least he got a couple of kills there. And he went that deep in the kill. Top lane. Seen up towards top. Takes a Lucent Beam to the dome. Shuriken from the high ground. 20 HP. And unfortunately, the freaking Satyr throws the shockwave to the right instead of to the south, which would have killed
both
anyway.
Phoenix.
Although Phoenix. Fireballs? No. Not quite in range.
That would have been such a snipe if he actually got him. But a close call for the Storm Spirit. He'll survive by the skin of his teeth. Still the Storm isn't having the greatest time. Whenever he tries to show out on this map, only level 6 on the Storm, and he's died once, even though he is farming quite nicely.
Alright, so after that bottom lane squabble, Phoenix has grabbed himself level 6, and Xiaotulay did escape from that one. Ultrakin getting a couple kills as well. Because he's having such a bad laning stage, he's more inclined to dive and trade his life for kills, since he's not worth that much, and the benefit is definitely going to outweigh the cost. EP are on a kind of pushing style lineup. They do have the Dragon Form up on the DK, and Luna is getting to a point where they can consider going for, at the very least, a couple of pokes in the enemy tier 1 towers. Like, just having Luna hit a tower a couple times, and the damage adds up super, super quick. But over in mid, actually, you're gonna lift up onto KK, dive in from the Phoenix. Supernova is there, which will burn down the Razor. Here comes the Storm Spirit, going straight 5400 right now. Gets the kill. Supernova, however, will erupt, not stunning the Storm Spirit. Ultra gets another Dragon Tail, and that may be enough. Storm Spirit doesn't have enough mana, doesn't have enough time. Will go down. Chang has arrived with the charge to Old Chicken, but they have no more follow up. This guy is too tanky. Now Chang is on the run, has no mana for another strike. Old Chicken has another Dragon Tail, will throw it with another Phoenix dive in. They'll kill off the Spirit Breakers. A 3-for-1 in the middle lane, and Phoenix is going to collect huge off of that, as is Old Chicken. In the meantime, Luna was left alone to push the tower. That was a disastrous fight for newbie.
Absolutely. One of the saddest things in Dota is watching a Spirit Breaker with Fire Spirits on him try to hit something. His base attack time is so terrible already that Fire Spirits hurt terribly for him. He actually can't get any attacks through. And now they're going to use those same Fire Spirits to farm up a fairly hefty stack. That's at least a 4 stack if I'm counting correctly. A lot of gold for the Phoenix.
Oh man, that's so much cash. That should give him, well, not completely his hand of might, especially since he's kind of getting roughed up by these creeps, but he should be very close to that. And I think even more importantly, the fact that this Bounty Hunter is going to collect a lot of experience from this as well. That's going to be his level 6. So track now up online, 10 minutes in. Not the fastest track I've ever seen in the world, but still at a reasonable clip. They also have Luna, who's packing the Helm of Dominator, so she'll be starting to stack a couple more Ancient Cams. Hasn't really been doing a ton of that as a team, but now they'll start doing it. Pretty much EP are firing off on all cylinders, and right now, this is where you would expect newbie Miracle to be at their strongest and EP to be at their weakest, the laning stage. And it's gone pretty well for newbie Miracle across the board as far as the CS is concerned, but outside of that, EP have been fighting extremely well, much better than newbie Miracle, and they've pretty much salvaged the fact that their laning stage is going to be poor with all their fighting.
Yeah, and in all honesty, I think they're just outplaying newbie Miracle inside of all of these fights, and I don't think it's to take anything away from newbie Miracle, but they're starting to slip in this game. They need to get the Storm active, and they need to start using the Finger of Death and Laguna Blade to get kills. Laguna Blade is actually so far away from being up. The Lina is only level 4. That's very surprising to me. She needs some catch-up time. She'll get some soaked experience in mid, but that's not the biggest of deals. In the meantime, Bounty Hunter is going to take experience from a stack coming out from the Storm Spirit. That's half a level for the bounty that he didn't spend anything for, really. Oh, charge over onto the Phoenix.
Very far away, uses the Supernova to dodge the stun. There's not enough heroes here to actually crack it, but they do see Lei, they do see 5400, and they actually are going to turn around for the Lina. That's one track kill already, and the Rubick's actually charging away. Here comes the Eclipse, that's going to kill up the Razor immediately, as well as drop Christina very, very low, gets a little bit more ball lightning, trying to go for this Rubick, charge out, may kill the Rubick on impact. No, it won't. It's just going to get Chang very far away from that fight, but no one EP dies. Now the chase is on. Oh man, I don't think I've ever seen this before, but this is not something that the Rubick wants to fully commit to. It's just a bad idea. He will cancel it, gets Netherstruck, and gets killed off. What the hell was that? They do see the line, I think, but I think Rubick only did that because he knows that his team is ahead. They might circle around for Chang yet. They have an invisor on Old Chicken, so maybe he can disengage away from this. Charge is there. No Lucent Beam, no Dragon Tail. He's going to get back to the middle lane, actually. Or somewhere. He's going to get to safety at the very least. Ultimately, however, EP get a couple of track kills. I think that was 2 track kills, and they may get a tower. They will get at least 1.
Rubick was so close to surviving that fight, too. He almost dies on, if not single-digit HP, double-digit HP, but oh, looks like they're going to find a jump. Finger of Death. Poor Rubick. He's going to end up going down another time. Up in top lane, on a similar note, Lina is going to die very easily, too.
The even trades numerically, but that was a track involved on the EP side, and losing the Rubick, who already has level 7, not a terribly huge deal. Fortify is going to keep the mid tier 1 alive, but only Phoenix is here, yet Phoenix is all you need for a tower deny. Here comes TP, here comes Luna. Tower is going to drop to deny range, and with EP bringing in the cavalry, we may see another fight right now. DK has no dragon form for another 20 seconds, there's no eclipse for another minute, and there's no tower. However, the charge will be cancelled. There is still Supernova on EP's side, so newbie don't get as much gold as they really wanted to from the tower. 5-12 in EP, are starting this engine up a lot faster than I really thought they would. Hand of Midas is completed on the Phoenix, plus they have items coming up in the DK in the form of BKB on the works, and Fawn, who is just dishing out the damage at this point. Newbie Miracle need to get better initiations off. They actually need to, you know, jump in onto someone, ideally the Luna, kill him off, and then take the fight.
Yeah, Luna, even though he is doing a lot of damage inside these engagements, with the 3 points in the Moonglaives, with Helm of Dominator, Yasha, is still very susceptible to being killed. And also the Lion, very susceptible to being killed. As he's caught up by the Breathe Fire, they'll shuriken him down, and now this should be a track kill on Lina as well. Even though two support kills usually isn't that big of a deal, it is when both of them are tracked with four heroes involved. That's quite a gold swing. Even when you're ahead, that's huge.
And Lion actually just went over here and then tried to TP. I don't know why he actually TP'd or where he was going, but the EP Observe Reward, the Dire Reward, right on this high ground, gave them the full vision that two heroes were coming in and DK was in the right position at the right time. So much extra cash. And Bounty Hunter, he's 3-0-4 right now, which is already really good. Had a pretty slow start, but ever since he got that track, which is just 4 minutes ago, he's gotten like, what, 4 or 5 track kills, something like that? And he's well on his way to his mech. Is it flying out to him? No, not just yet. So he's not that far ahead, but still, he is extremely big right now. And they're actually going to go for another kill in the form of Christina. They only have the telekinesis. He's going to try to TP out. Oh, he's not looking. He's going to get lifted up and tail at the same time, but the burst damage is there. Elsei, a little bit late to save the Storm Spirit, and Lina may pay the price because of it. There's the track, and there's a supernova. Lina will burn. That's a little bit of karma for her. That's two track kills for Newbie Miracle, as Storm Spirit was clearly just staring at the bottom lane, thinking about teleporting down there. They lose that tower as well.
5-16, this game is becoming unmanageable for Newbie Miracle. It really only took the Bounty Hunter's track to do it, but as soon as they got that tool, Energy Pacemaker found so many good exchanges. Charging to the Phoenix, he's hexed up, but the follow-up disable just isn't there, and poor Lion, he'll finger down the Phoenix and actually survives. I'm surprised that he lived for that long. Now Rubick is isolated. Oh, finally Newbie Miracle gets something. That went a lot better than I would have given them credit for.
That's just Fog of War and the fact that DK is a melee hero. Like, if he was ranged there, then they probably could have gotten at least one kill, and Dragon Tail would have at least saved another, but yeah, it's really hard to actually get in when there's not many ways to actually approach into this area. Yes, that drawing is exactly correct. So Old Chicken not having that Dragon Form there, really not exactly helping out the situation. Newbie get a couple of kills, which is fine, but at this point they need so much more than a couple of kills on, you know, a semi-low level Phoenix and a semi-low level Rubick. It's just not quite enough. They need to kill off the DK, they need to kill off the Luna a couple of times. Hell, Fan hasn't even died yet. He has a 5-kill streak. And once he has this Manta style, which I assume he's going to go for with his 1800 gold in the bank, he's going to be so much more difficult to kill. At least they get a tower deny, which is pretty sweet.
Although Phoenix and Rubick are relative to their own teammates low level, well, even the Phoenix is actually not that low. He's level 11. That's Midas going to work there. If you compare their levels to the enemy team, it's not pretty at all. The Lina is just now going to hit her level 6, and I'm not even sure when that's going to happen. And the Storm Spirit's the same level as the supports on the Dire team. It's really starting to get gross. Bounty Hunter is deep behind enemy lines. If they have a sentry down on the ground, this could be a good pickoff for them, but right now Lay is undetected. They know he's there now. He drops a track onto the Lion, but I think he should be able to evade this. No, he stops walking inside the trees. What? Those trees were destroyed. They had vision of him and now charged. He's in a lot of trouble. I think what's a good question. I honestly don't know. Dusted up. Looks like he's going to go down. That was such a weird play. Now the Supernova going in. It is a level 2 Supernova, and with the Charge 4 coming up of the Rubick and the Eclipse, they'll keep it alive and turn things around for 4 kills for the team, and now chase forward. Ball Lightning TP, will that succeed? It will. Storm Spirit will make it home back to base, but he's the only one.
I want to believe that the entire thing that Bounty Hunter just did there was an elaborate bait, right? Because it worked out pretty well. Like, they
it really did.
I thought Spirit Breaker was going to come in a lot faster, but I didn't realize he was that far away, so I thought Bounty Hunter was just dead. That was not a good play by the Bounty Hunter in the least, but it drew Newbie into a position where they were very far ahead with no creeps, and well, Supernova cleaned out anything else along the way as well. Then between the Supernova and Eclipse, which should just like break Earth, it was a huge cleanup for Newbie, so they got just completely baited in by the Bounty Hunter. Again, I want to believe that was an intentional play, but obviously, you would like to get those kills with track in the future, but I'm pretty sure they'll be okay with a 4-for-1 trade. EP also get the tower.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure what happened there is Bounty Hunter just wasn't checking that the trees were destroyed and kind of went on autopilot there, expecting there to be Fog of War, but Yeah, it worked out. You can't knock it that much. Phoenix is going to be spotted out by the enemy team, but no disables are going to go her way. The supports are so far away from having Blink Dagger's Lions halfway there, but 18 minutes and that takes so long. Oh, Bounty Hunter might get spotted out shortly, walks over the Sentry Ward, and there is a charge going his way, but there's also a charge in from Rubick. 6-2-1 will get the two-man Light Strike away with the Laguna Blade. They'll kill off one, and now chase forward for two. 5,400 will hit the deck, and the charge forward will continue on to Creeps. A little bit overambitious coming up from Energy Pacemaker, but it works out for Newbie Miracle. Finally, they get a little bit of something, but they're going to need more where that came from if they want to get back into this game.
Again, two kills is really nice, and EP trying to be a little bit greedy with the heroes that they use the kills, the heroes that they use to try to get those kills, because charge on Rubick is not exactly impressive. They're going to try to go for Origami down towards bottom. There's a Supernova. Will it pop in time? Not even close. Lion will take a lot of damage, though. Supernova. That's a pretty long cooldown, so Phoenix is going to be pretty bummed about that one, but still, losing the Bounty Hunter, losing the Rubick. To put everything in context, this Bounty Hunter has a Mechanism and Arcane Boots, and so does the Razor pretty much, and Razor was solo mid, and Bounty Hunter was roaming, so he's doing pretty well for himself, and now he's going to do a little bit better since the team is going to clear Roshan, and Newbie, they do have pretty good heroes at crashing this party. The problem is that, this is such a safe Roshan because Luna has Lifesteal and DK is DK, that if they do get into a fight, they'll be walking into an Eclipse, and that's not really what you want to have happen.
Yeah, they don't have to worry about Supernova, so at the very least, there's that, but this Phoenix also has a completed Rod of Atos. The farm on these supports and offlaners for Energy Pacemaker is no joke. They'll charge forward for Phoenix, but lifted up Spiritbreaker, now in a bit of trouble. But then again, so is Rubick. Isolated from Esther's team, the Lagoon Blade, sparing no expenses to get that kill. The Eclipse comes through, coming out from Fan as he goes into the back lines. Poor 621 is going to go down with the Shuriken bouncing through everyone. That's a triple Shuriken. They'll chase forward for the Razor, get that kill. One shot from Old Chicken's all that they need. Now Chang will be chased down. Lucid Beam and Breathe Fire, and next to fall will be Lion, slated for his death in just a second with a blink in Dragon Tail. They can't even get off the Lucid Beam. It's a 4-for-2 trade, but at the very least three of those kills were tracked.
I'm pretty sure they dumped both of their ultimates into that Rubick. Wasn't watching that entirely, but Rubick died real quick, and Phoenix didn't last too long either, but Phoenix didn't even have a Supernova there, so him dying, not really a huge deal. It's not like they denied a whole bunch of damage out from that one. EP, they kept the DK alive, they kept the Luna alive, and that Eclipse is level 3 at this point. It absolutely shredded the newbie side. Even with the mech, like, it started, Christina's gonna get Dragon-Tailed from very far away. LSA will bail him out. Storm Spirit barely going to live. But still, they have Aegis on this Luna. She is really big with 5,400 gold. Oh my god. That's track working overtime for you, especially when she got so many kills. Still is 8-0-7. Fawn has not really been under any pressure in this entire game, not for like any significant moment.
No, she has the top last hits, top denies in this game, and yeah, a great KDA to match it. At this point, as the Luna, honestly not sure what you build. You could go for anything feasibly. Honestly, just going for a straight butterfly could be cool if she wants to play it safe, BKB, or finish up the Manta, disassemble the Sanjin Yasha. There's a world of options for her because she just has so much in the bank. And even if she doesn't spend it, she's still sitting comfortably at the top of the net worth chart.
Man, Sanjin Yasha used to break Luna, like you wouldn't actually attack at all if you brought this item, but yeah, now it's actually a not terrible item. Chang, gonna get caught by Old Chicken. If he does charge out, he will charge down to the low ground into a shuriken and into a lift. It was a perfectly executed gank, and well, here comes everyone else as well. Chang will go down, giving yet another track gold to EP. And with the death of the Spirit Breaker, and with the momentum on the top lane, looks like Tier 2 tower on top is bound to fall, although Old Chicken runs into a whole pile of heroes, gets a Dragon Tail off, gets the blink away, Lion didn't cast anything for some reason, gets the Hex on the 5400 spike, completely whiffing however. Now here comes the Solar Boom, Old Chicken as well getting in there with splash damage, 621, taking a beating, he's gonna fall first, Origami the second to fall, that's a track kill. That's 3 kills total for EP, Old Chicken taking literally no damage from any of that. And Newbie, they're not even landing their skills at this point. What could they really do up against this Luna, who just straight bought a butterfly?
Yeah, at 22 minutes in, that's unheard of amounts of farm for Fan. Tier 2 tower is going to fall. And the extra gold from these kills is not to be understated. It's a level 2 track. That's like 500 gold per each of these kills. Stormstrat will survive by the skin of his teeth, but early the Storm is struggling to put together enough gold to finish up his Bloodstone. The items just don't compare at face value, and his net worth is a lot closer to Rubick than it is to Luna. And speaking of Luna, he's gonna drop the Eclipse onto the poor Razor. He'll be able to mech and keeps himself alive, but now that Luna's coming back up, this gets very scary. Phoenix will burn down the Lina, and the Razor and Storm Spirit can do nothing but walk into their base as their tier 3 towers are under heavy siege. Chang is going to get his Nether Strike stolen, and he'll be killed off. Double kill for the Phoenix.
And those were track kills, both of them. So EP with that much extra gold. This Luna doesn't have a BKB, which at this point is like never ever seen, but I don't really think she cares that much because she's dishing so much damage. She may lose her godlike streak here though, because she's getting way far out of position. Finger of Death is there, plus the charge. Heal from the Solar Beam, gonna keep her alive a little bit longer as Chang gets Tornado up into the air. Big ball ending in, trying to go for Fawn, knowing that if they get this kill, that'll be huge, and they may very well get it, but the plasma field just misses, and now Luna's free and clear. They're gonna chase forward, look for whoever else they can get. Maybe it's going to be this Phoenix, but 5400 glimmers into the trees. Lei is completely invis. They still see Fawn. Do they? They should know where he is. We have a charge going towards the Phoenix. Chang should be able to secure that kill just by himself. And Luna now is going to rejoin with the rest of the team. Urn Charge is there. She's now able to turn around and fight. They're going to get right onto this Luna. That's going to be a track kill. KK is also tracked. That's going to be another. Spike is there, but Fawn is still surviving. And he can chase forward for more. That's a third track kill. Here comes the charge. Chang trying to get this kill. Nether Strike not happening, though, because he gets chances on and Fawn lives. Oh my god, this Luna is playing things fast and loose, but it's a complete team wipe with like four track kills at least.
That's gross. I don't have words for that. The Luna is obscenely overfarmed and has so much backup from the rest of the team. The Phoenix almost survives his Spiritbreaker to add insult to injury. He was chasing after. Oh, long ball in. Fan is getting jumped, but with the butterfly, she still might survive. How many misses are you going to get, Fan? Man fighting the Storm Spirit. Can't do it. Oh, with the Remnant, he can, but the Blade Bounce is almost killing him off. Ooh, that was a close call. That's ridiculous. But look how much money Storm just got for that kill. That's okay. that's
easy 2K, that's, man.
I don't know. I don't have words for that. That doesn't happen.
Unfortunately, Lina can't really do much with the 2,000 that she got. Like, a Blink Dagger is going to do next to nothing in this scenario. Just way too late for it. We do actually have Origami being stalked by a Bounty Hunter with a Dagon. And there goes the Lion. Not even tracked, actually. Lei just wants to get the kill. I think that's probably the correct decision. Might as well get the kill as opposed to being hexed up, spiked, and then maybe even killed in response. But EP, they collect huge off of that fight. Their entire team. They have Yule Scepter on this Bounty Hunter. They have a Blink Glimmer on this Rubick. They have freaking Moon Shards on this DK. And it's going to be one of the few times we see Moon Shards being held on the hero. And Phoenix has the completed Rod of Atos plus a Plate Mail. Plus, they're going to run into KK right now. There's going to be a track this time. Charge is coming in, and Rubick is taking a beating right now. Glimmer is going to try to do it, but he's spotted by Chen the entire time. Here comes Christina. That's a dead Rubick. And Lei, he's going to get dusted up as well. They still have that Nether Strike. They're going to pull him back, kill him off. And EP are going to lose two more heroes. Here comes Old Chicken. He wants in by himself. Probably not a good idea. They will actually not be in a great position right now since Storm Spirit's on the bottom. And here's the charge. There's a Supernova to help him disengage, perhaps. Charge is actually gonna cancel. Is he stuck in those trees? I don't really know, but Phoenix is gonna dive over everyone regardless. Now here comes Fan with the Eclipse prepped and ready. He's not gonna use it just yet. There it is. Not gonna do a whole lot, but no one's dying on EP either. KK is gonna die first. Now they're gonna try to go for the Storm Spirit, but they don't have the lockdown necessary. Chang's gonna charge the creep wave, which may very well end up killing him, and it will. DK ultimately gets credit for that one. No track kills for EP, but these are the three heroes that are difficult to kill for EP, for newbie rather, and EP are showing why.
It's really just such a difficult game for a newbie Miracle at this point. Honestly, it might just be a GG territory, even though they still hold on to two sets of their barracks. I don't think it matters if you just take a look at the rock farm that Energy Pacemaker have over the top of newbie M. Look at how fast that Dragonite's hitting the tower. This is 27 minutes in the game. They'll zip in. Yeah, it really is just not fair. And what also is not fair, Dragontail onto the Storm Spirit. Although he will be back quickly, since he has the Bloodstone. When he's back, his melee barracks won't be there. And with the Finger of Death Laguna combo, or no, they didn't use the Finger of Death, just the Laguna onto the Phoenix. They'll kill him off, but in trade, they'll lose Origami beyond godlike for Old Chicken.
And that should be it. Two Raxes down, and Nubia already are, I don't really want to press it. Oh my god, 30,000, 20,000 behind in golden experience. If they get completely team wiped, and it looks like they will with the charger, they might lose a couple heroes, but no one's focusing on Fawn, actually. They're actually all going for Old Chicken, which is kind of what EP want. Now it's time for Luna to man the hell up. Where are you going, Luna? Get back in there. She gets a Satanic delivered. Still running, Fawn? Really? Come on. There you go. Now gonna turn around. The burst damage, though, and the disable is potentially a little bit too high. Found gets the Satanic off, tries to lifesteal, gets absolutely none of it. And now the Phoenix is going to get lifted up with a Cyclone, dropped into an LSA, beaten down as well. 322, it's never too late to throw, but I'm pretty sure even with that EP, have all the time in the world to slow push the bottom lane. I think
that
fight is over.
Yeah, it probably is. But if we just take a look at how much gold Newbie Miracle got from that, it's ridiculous. And oh, they'll find a freebie over on the sideline. It's a Rubick too. That's a gold swing of 6,000 and an experience swing of almost 10k. That's ridiculous. Even through buying back two heroes. Not that it matters. Having two barracks advantage at less than 30 minutes of the game is pretty much good game no matter how you slice it. Unless, of course, you lose everybody with no buyback, but that's also not the case. Lay, oh, he's gonna get spotted out with the Urza Spike. They might be able to kill off this bounty. It is a delayed full five-man wipe coming out from Newbie Miracle, but the fact of the matter is that tier 2 towers still stand in all of these lanes, and there's buyback up for the DK and the Luna.
Well, buybacks were actually used on EP's side. I guess some were used on Newbie's side as well, but I mean, even with all of that gold swing, Luna has doubled the Razor's net worth, and if she ever decides to get a good item like BKB, then they just cannot kill her. It is just not going to happen. So she's obviously not going to go for that because she's feeling like so much of a baller. She could probably go for a Daedalus or something. I'm not sure if I'm lagging right now or if Luna is not buying anything. Okay, kind of both. So yeah, Fawn can get whatever she wants. Old Chicken, I can't click on him. Moonshard's crit now coming up. He's going to go for that Daedalus, and that's actually very close to being completed. Still no BKBs on these heroes, but I don't really think it matters.
Yeah, I mean, we talked in the draft how BKBs would be pretty important for them, but they're so far ahead that it just doesn't matter, especially now after they clean up a 5-stack of Ancients, I want to say. A ridiculous amount of gold. And it looks like Luna wants to get onto the Moonshard train as well.
Oh my god, KK buys a Maelstrom. Razor, the lightning hero. Christina, you have to buy one as well. Then you get a flavor wind. You may lose the game, but you'll win our hearts. And that's really what's most important.
Absolutely. In reality, the Maelstrom is still a pretty good item on the Razor. They just need any way to push out these lanes. But even with it, Razor's struggling, and Spirit Breaker even more so. They just don't have the appropriate heroes to deal with these supersized creeps.
It's a moon shard on Luna.
Well, her attack speed is 0.39. Gross. Even without Manta Style, there's going to be so many glaives bouncing through the base, and these are no joke. They're going to be hitting for 273 a pop.
Mercy, please. Mercy, yeah. Please, Bond.
I really don't want to be the lion in this next fight with 910 max HP.
And with the Blink Dagger, like, all your net worth went into this one item that is probably going to get canceled by a random bounce. They're going to dive right in, trying to go for the Phoenix. Sees them coming, though. No Supernova this time. Lift up onto the line. They're going to go for the Supernova first. They'll bring him down before they can actually get it, but the Eclipse is there, and Bond is holding his ground. The Glaives are bouncing, and they hurt like hell. Razor down already, now going towards Chang. Slow to a crawl because of that DK Ice. They'll take him down. Now Old Chicken's going to blink up to the high ground. Going to go for 621. Should take her down as well. That's a triple kill for Old Chicken in exchange for their Phoenix. Origami going to try to TP out. Will almost straight die to the splash damage. That's 50% splash damage, yet it was almost enough, and that's going to be GG. Fawn takes no damage, all of that, and Newbie, they get a Phoenix.
A commanding win coming out from Energy Pacemaker. From start to finish, it really kind of felt like they had the slight edge, although the laning stage looked okay, or at least within reasonable bounds for Newbie Miracle when it came to CS. They were just getting outplayed. They lost most of the engagements. They couldn't find good rotations, and really the strengths that we pointed out in the draft never were relevant since they were so far behind, especially the Luna, absolutely out of control, 808 GPM.
Yeah, that's more than any hero should have. Like, I think Alchemist is probably the only exception. If I saw an Alchemist with that, I'll be like, okay, that's maybe even a slow game for the Alchemist, but 808 GPM on her. I think the real weird GPM in this game is the Bounty Hunter. This is a support roaming Bounty Hunter with like 50 track kills and 520 gold per minute. That's just not supposed to happen, man. You're not supposed to get that many track kills. And Newbie, I think they always had, or for the greater part of this game, they had the power of initiation on their side with Spirit Breaker and the Storm Spirit. They were just never in the proper position at the right time. They couldn't abuse the fact that Luna was, you know, kind of, always arriving late to the party. She was never really targetable by this initiation. And because of that, they always got cleaned up by the Eclipse and the Supernova. They just burned all of their skills at all the wrong heroes. But Newbie, not getting completely rolled over, just mostly rolled over. So that means they have a chance for game two, guys. This is going to go to a two-game series as it should, as it always is going to for right now. And we'll see if Newbie can bring it back. But again, up against EP, the vast favorites. Guys, I'm Mike Loris. I've been joined by Grandis V, and we'll both be right back for game